The Genesis conception of creation is threefold. There's the sea of chaos, the cosmic sea, referred to in Revelation and in the famous hymn as the glassy sea, and the earth. Chaos is the abiding characteristic of the sea. The paradox of the ancient world was that travel over land was slow and at risk from robbery. Sea travel was much quicker, but liable to shipwreck. The sea, as in the Jonah story, is always threatening. The crossing of the Red Sea is a sign of God's mastery over chaos, and when Jesus later walks on water and calms the Sea of Galilee, he shows a similar dominance over all that oppresses us. Job speaks of the Leviathan, the monster who rises out of the deep, again something that God finally conquers. Revelation has a sea of fire and a beast from the sea, but eventually in the final version, there is no more sea and chaos is over. Herbert Sumsion's setting of Psalm 107 was written in 1979 for Dennis Kiddie and the choir of Repton Prep School. It has a rippling, listless organ part with an attractive solo melody.
Thank you.
William Whiting was inspired by the dangers of the sea described in Psalm 107 and his own experience of sailing. He wrote his famous hymn, Eternal Father, to encourage a young seaman scared of sailing. The hymn has a long association with the Royal Navy and is sung at Sunday Eucharist at the Old Royal Naval College Chapel in Greenwich. It was sung on August the 9th, 1941, at a service aboard the Royal Navy battleship HMS Prince of Wales, attended by Winston Churchill, who requested that the hymn be sung, and Franklin D. Roosevelt at the conference creating the Atlantic Charter. The tune Melita is named after Malta, where Paul was shipwrecked. Alfred Lord Tennyson wrote Crossing the Bar as he contemplated the approach of his own death. In the poem, he describes his confidence in moving from safe harbor to the unknown ocean beyond. He speaks of Christ as the pilot who has been on board all the while, but in the dark has remained unseen. God is, for Tennyson, that divine and unseen who is always guiding us.